Hello friends, in this video let us learn how to file GSTR1 by using offline utility tool. For that, firstly ensure you are using Marg ERP Series C latest version. For that, you can download from our website, that is www.margcompusoft.com, and install in your PC. And you can also download the latest version of GST patch from our website and paste it in your Marg folder as well.
Before filing GSTR1, you must ensure that there are no errors in any of your invoices. In Marg ERP software, there is a feature under Internal Audit option through which the software will indicate all the errors which exist in your invoices. In order to correct the errors in the invoices, you will go to Masters, Ease of GST Adoption, and then click on Item GST Percentage, then enter on Accept. Here you will press F8 function key in order to find unmatched items. With the help of this, all the tax mismatch items will get filtered. Suppose this is an item whose HSN you have already set. Here it is showing that there is a mismatch in the tax percent of this particular item and the tax percent of item in the item master. In order to correct, you will press enter and you will correct this. So in this way, after correcting all the tax percent and the HSN code of the items, you will go to final reports, internal audit, internal audit GSTR mismatch. Then you will specify the dates from which date till which date you need to see the invoices that contain errors. So a list of all the invoices will get open that contain errors. At the side of the software, you can see the type of errors which are there in the invoices. First type of error is ignorable errors. This type of errors can be ignored. Second type of error is correct with resaving. This means that you need to just simply resave those invoices that contains errors as specified here. The errors in the invoices will automatically get corrected once resaved. Next is manual correction required. These are those errors which need to be corrected manually. If you need to see the details, that is how you will correct these errors, then for that you will press F9 function key. On pressing F9 function key, the software displays the description of the errors and also shows that how to solve that particular error, which is indicated with purple color. In order to go back, press F9 function key. If you want to remove those invoices from this list in which ignorable errors exist, then you will press delete key. Then enter on ignorable errors here. If you will enter on delete single record, then only that particular invoice gets deleted, which is currently being selected. And if you will enter on delete same errors, then the error on the invoice which is correctly selected, then all the invoices with those errors will get deleted. For now, we will delete all the ignorable errors by entering on delete ignorable errors. Now, correct with resaving and manual correction errors are left. In order to remove the correct with resaving errors, we will select all the invoices first with the help of asterisk key. Then press F6 function key and then enter on resave bills. So in this way, your bills will get resaved and the errors will also get corrected automatically. Now, only manual correction errors are left. These are those errors which needs to be corrected manually. For example, there are two bills whose tax mismatch exists in SGST and CGST. You can press F1 function key here and select that error so that both the bills gets displayed in front of you. And now you need to press enter on each bill and correct it separately. Now there was a tax mismatch error of SGST and CGST in this invoice. So in order to correct it, we will go down and then press page up key here. Then here for load tax type, we will select yes. Then we will save this. So for rest of the bills also, you will set yes for the tax type so that the tax mismatch error of SGST and CGST gets corrected. So in this way, you will correct all the manual correction error invoices. Then once again, you will now go to final reports, internal audit, internal audit GSTR mismatch. And if it shows that no mismatch found, Here then it means that all your errors has been corrected and there is no error in any of your invoices. So you can now file your GSTR1.
To view this report, go to Final Reports, GST Returns, then enter on GSTR1. As you will enter on GSTR1, this window will appear, where firstly you will enter the period from which date to till which date you have to file the return, then click on Show button. Now we'll enter on Excel Returns and from here we'll enter on GSTN Excel Sheet and we'll click on Start button. Now here you will see software ask you that are you sure to prepare CSV Excel Sheet? So we will click on Yes. So software will start generating Excel file according to government format. Now you can see an Excel sheet will get generated. For viewing the Excel sheet, you will open the Marg folder, then enter on GST return folder. So here you can view that the Excel file has been generated. After that, you will go to government website, that is gst.gov.in. From here, click on Downloads, then Offline Tool, then click on Returns Offline Tool. And from here, click on Download and download the offline tool. Here, you can see that it is asking, are you sure you want to download this utility? You will enter on Proceed. So you can see that the offline tool is downloading here. After downloading the offline tool, you will go to the Downloads folder. Here you can see a zip file is shown here. You have to right click on that and select Extract Here option. Now the folder is being extracted here, that is GST Offline Tool. Now we will open the folder by double clicking on it. And now you will install the GST Offline Tool. For installing it, you will double click on it and then Next click on it. Again click on Next, then click on Next and then install it. Then you can see here the installation has been completed. Then simply you will click on Finish. And now you will come to your desktop. So here you can see GST Offline Tool icon has been showing at your desktop. For to run this, you will simply double click on it. As you will double click on it, this window will appear in front of you. And from here, you will click on New button. After that, you will mention the GSTIN of the supplier. Then from here, you will select the tax period. Means for which month you are filing the return. That month, you will select from here. After that is aggregate turnover in the preceding financial year. Here you will enter your last year turnover. After that, the next field is aggregate turnover April to June 2017. Means here you will enter your current year quarterly turnover, then you will click on Proceed. After that, from here you will click on Import Files. Then from here, click on Import Excel and select that generated Excel file and from here, we will open it. Here you will see it is asking you that are you sure you want to save the data. So from here, we will enter on Yes. So here your data is importing. And one thing you need to remember here, that in this file if you have found any errors, so that errors will be shown here. Our data have been successfully imported. Now simply from here, you will click to view summary. So it will show your all summary here. As here, you can see how many number of invoices are there in B2B. Same as you can see how many number of invoices in B2C large. And along with that, you can see the number of IGST, number of total cess, the complete summary you can view here. After that, you will click on Generate File. Then from here, we'll click on Save File and then click on OK button. And as you will click on OK, so it will generate a JSON file. What you will do is, you will come to your Downloads folder. Here you can see JSON file has been generated. Now we will upload this file on the GST portal. For that, you will again switch to gst.gov.in and click on Login. Then here you will enter your username and password. and whatever digit you have shown here, you will enter here and simply click on login button. And from here, you will click on return dashboard and select the period for which month return you are filing. As we are selecting the month July, then simply click on search. Then you will click on prepare offline. After that, from here you will click on choose file. And the JSON file which we have saved, we will select that JSON file and then we will click on open. So now here you can see in status is showing processed, and also you can see here showing you which date, at which time and at with reference ID you have been uploaded invoices. And now from here your invoices had been uploaded, means your GSTR1 has been filed. So in this way, we have seen in our today's video that how you can file your return by using offline utility. Thank you.